In this video, I'm going to show you how I use Adobe Fresco to create fun animated graphics to use in my videos on this YouTube channel. So I have a Fresco document open here, and I've got this little pointy finger that I want to use to point to things in my videos when I'm doing tutorials and things like that. What I'm going to do first is just animate this a little bit, and I'm just going to put it on a little path so it just moves up and down a little bit, just so it's not static. I feel like it'll give it a little bit more energy, make it a little bit more fun. So I'm gonna click on the animation button at the bottom right and then hit path. And then I'm just gonna draw a little line like that. That's pretty good. And then I'm just gonna decrease the amount of frame so it's moving a little bit faster. Maybe I'll even try the ease in, ease out option to make it a little more natural of a movement. I think that's perfect. So I'll just stop this and I'm going to go up to the top to publish and export and then go to motion. And here I'm going to choose PNG sequence from the options, and then I'll hit generate frames, and this will give us our little sequence. So I'm gonna hit export, and then I'm just gonna choose to airdrop this to my MacBook Pro. If you're working on Windows or something like that, you could just save it to Dropbox or wherever else you use to save files so that you can access it when you're on your computer. And now we're done. Now we can head over to the computer. All right, so on my computer, I see this little zip file that was sent over from my iPad. I'm gonna double click on this, and we're gonna get a PNG set folder. One thing that I like to do is just change the file name so it's not just PNG, because sometimes I have a whole bunch of different graphics that I've done this way, and it can get confusing when I'm in the editing software. An easy way to do this when you're on a Mac is to select all of them and then right click and go to rename. And this will give us a handy little tool that we can do a find and replace. So I'm gonna change find to PNG and then replace with point. So anywhere it says PNG, it's now gonna say point. So I'll hit rename, and now we have them all ready to go. The reason we did find and replace as opposed to just changing them all is because this allows us to keep the numbering sequence so that they're in the right order. Okay, now I'm in Final Cut Pro in a new project. I'm gonna go to File, Import, Media, and then I'm gonna find that image sequence. So we got it here. And make sure they are all selected, and then do import selected. Now you'll see all of our image sequence right over here. So I'm gonna select all of those and then just press E to send those to my timeline. So I'm gonna zoom out to see the whole timeline here, and then I'm going to select all of them doing Command A. What we need to do now is shorten the duration, because the problem is when you insert an image into video editing software, it usually defaults to be up for like 5 seconds or something like that. So in Final Cut Pro, you can just do Control D, and that changes the duration of how long each is up. So then I'll just hit 2, which is gonna make it 2 frames. The reason I'm picking 2 is because my video is gonna be in 24 frames per second, and my animation is in 12 frames per second. That's animating on 2s, so every other frame gets a thing. It's a little confusing. You don't have to understand, but a handmade animation, something that you do in Fresco, will generally play pretty well at 12 frames per second. So then I'm just gonna hit return, and it's gonna shorten this all up so we can select that whole sequence and then make it into a compound clip. And then I'll just call this point. And now I have this point sequence there ready to go so that we can use it on top of our video. Let me pull a video clip in here and show you what I'm talking about. So I have this screen recording up here where I'm talking about selecting the grow shrink button. And because it's a screen recording, it's a little bit hard to see what I'm doing because my hands aren't there. So having this little arrow will be helpful to point to what I'm talking about. So I'm going to move the playhead to where that grow shrink button gets selected. And I'm gonna go ahead and grab my point sequence, drag this onto my timeline, and obviously it's big and ridiculous, and I'm just going to go ahead and rotate that and then bring the size down, and I'm just gonna move it over to grow shrink. So then we can see what it looks like there. I actually think that it's moving a little too slow, and I also want it to be up longer. So to do that, all I'm gonna do is take this sequence, I'm gonna hold option and drag to have more than one, and I'm just gonna make a whole bunch of these so I can have it as long as I want. So I think that is probably good enough. And then I can select all of these, then do a new compound clip, and we can call this point sequence longer. So I'm gonna just select that sequence, click on this button over here on the bottom left where we can adjust the time. And then I'm just gonna go into custom, and then just bump this up, let's say 150%, and then we'll see how that looks. I think that's pretty good. We can also drag this to make it go even faster. Okay, I think I'm okay with that. So now all we need to do is just animate this into place. This is super easy in Final Cut Pro. I'm just gonna use a transition called Slide In, which is my default transition anyway. So I can just do Command T, and it's gonna put these little slide in effects here. So if we hit that, our little hand comes flying in, points where it's gonna go. And then we can come to this end and we can set it to fly out. So we can go up here to our inspector and go to slide out, and then we can have it keep going right. So let's watch the sequence. Pops in, points where it needs to go. Obviously, this is way longer than we need. Actually, you know what we can do? We can make the hand move down to go to the percentage. So let's adjust where this needs to be. So it turns on there. So we want this to, we want the hand to come in before that happens. So I'm gonna drag the sequence over, comes in, and then that goes, and then the percentage gets adjusted. So click on our sequence here. We can come up to our inspector window in the top right, and we can put in a keyframe to change the position. So we click on this little diamond shape in the top right, and then I'm going to just move the playhead down a little bit to when that thing starts getting activated, and then I'm going to hit this diamond thing again, and this will give us a new keyframe, and here we can change the position. So I'm just gonna move this down so that it's on that timeline. So let's play that back. So hand comes in, shows us that button, then slides down to the percentage. And then we can shorten the sequence and then do Command T to put that transition on, and then do slide out right. So it comes in, shows us grow shrink, moves down to percentage, then flies out. Pretty simple. Hope that was helpful. Oh, hey, one more thing. If you like this little pointy finger animation, I've made it available as a free download for you to use in your own project. You can find the link below. All right, good talk.